Cellectis, the French genome engineering specialist, is announcing the acquisition of Cellartis and a capital increase for 50 million euros in new capital. André Choulika, welcome.
Thank you for having me.
You are the chairman and CEO of Cellectis. First, what is the rationale for acquiring Cellartis?
Well, the rationale comes from Cellectis is a biotechnology group based on genome engineering. And we have developed the company into a series of subsidiaries. And one of these subsidiaries, incepted in 2009, is called Ecticel. Ecticel is based on the development of induced pluripotent stem cells, what we call iPS cells, where you take a differentiated cell and you can engineer the cell to become, after this, a stem cell, and then you can redifferentiate it for different type of industrial applications. On the other side, you have Cellartis, which is a European leader in the field of stem cells. Cellartis has 10 years experience in industrializing the differentiation of stem cells, such as liver cells or heart cells, for different type of pharmaceutical applications, for example, screening drugs, or they also have an application within a collaboration with Novo Nordisk for developing diabetes applications. We believe that Ecticel and Cellartis would form a group that would be a leader in the field of stem cells, not only European leader, but also a world leader in this field. And we are totally convinced that this leadership would take the company 3 to 4 years ahead in the development of what we're doing, and would take us as one of the world company in the field of regenerative medicine, which is the future of the current molecular medicine.
You're raising 50 million euros in new capital outside of the market. Could you tell us more about the terms of this transaction?
The terms of this transaction are based mainly on having into the shareholder basis of Cellectis two reference shareholders. And these two investors, which is the FSI, the France's sovereign wealth fund that will invest in Cellectis, which is something that is extremely important in terms of strategic development of Cellectis, including with Pierre Bastide, which is an industrial person that will invest in the company also. And these two shareholders will help us to consolidate the basis of our shareholders and also look forward in what's happening in the future. Not only this, but also as it's done outside the market, will compensate our current shareholders in providing them with warrants, and there will be one warrant provided for 5 shares that are held by our shareholders, which will help them and allow them to participate in this capital increase.
You're raising more money than actually needed for the sole acquisition of Cellartis. What will be your use of the additional proceeds?
Well, the use of proceeds, so there is a part of this money that will go for the acquisition of Cellartis, that's one part, but also once you've acquired a company and you merge this company to Ecticel, so Cellartis and Ecticel forms an entity, you will have to refinance this entity to become a success afterwards. And that's our objective. And part of the proceeds will go to the refinancing of this entity to make it a leader in the field of stem cells. Then there is a part of this money will go to agricultural biotechnology applications within one of our subsidiaries called Cellectis Plant Sciences, based in the United States. And then finally, the end of these proceeds will go to Cellectis BioResearch, developing industrial applications for research kits, but also bioproduction applications, and all the field of research and bioproduction will be covered by CBR, Cellectis BioResearch, and all the development that will go into it.
And finally, what is the medium-term outlook for Cellectis?
Well, the medium-term outlook of the company, which is also a long-term outlook for the company, is that we have a goal to become a world company in the field of life sciences. And not only a company, but a group. As you see, the company, how it has developed since the IPO in 2007, we have today 4 subsidiaries. In 2008, we have incepted Cellectis Therapeutics and Cellectis BioResearch, 2009 Ecticel, and 2010 Cellectis Plant Sciences. We have announced to the market that this development into changing the company from a small SME to a medium-sized company, which is a total change in scale of what we are currently implicated in, is external growth. And this is the first step in external growth that we're giving the company a trend and a momentum into the growth of the company. We have started the company in 2007. I think we're 36 people, and we're today, before the acquisition of Cellartis, 159 people. And after the acquisition of Cellartis, we'll be more than 200 people. And this build-up in external growth and all the subsidiaries we have will make the company an international group and a life science group that will become one of the leaders in this field.
André Choulika, Chairman and CEO of Cellectis, thank you very much.
Thank you very much.